You will need tan, red, green, brown, and yellow clay. I mixed my tan clay with the yellow to create my tortilla. I did this to give it more of like a dimension to the actual tortilla shell. As we all know, tortilla shells are not just all one color, so we don't want to make it that way. Now, once you've softened up your clay, you are going to just roll it out into a ball and then flatten it. You can make it nice and even, and then just take a sharp utensil and cut out a circle. I just eyeballed it, but you could use anything like a spice jar, cap, or cookie cutter, or whatever. You're gonna wanna kinda smooth out the edges of your tortilla so they're not sharp. And then you're just gonna kind of fold it in the way you want your taco to go, and this will give you an idea of like the size of the filling you wanna make. All right, it is time for the beef or the turkey or like whatever it is that you're into. I mixed my brown with the tan. When you cook ground beef or ground turkey, some parts are darker, some are burnt. I mean, it depends if you're me or not. So I just smeared this kind of around with my utensil like you would oil paints or anything like that. And then start filling your taco. Once you have your filling in place, you're gonna take like a sharp tool, a knife or a toothpick or whatever it is, and you're just gonna wanna poke at that to really make it look like ground beef. Time for the tomatoes. So I just rolled it. I did the same thing with the cheese. I rolled them in balls and boop, I just push them down and they make perfect little circles. And I just took a sharp kind of pointy tool and I scored them like a pizza. Once my tomatoes are all tomatified, I cut them in half and start filling. There's no wrong way to do this. Obviously, when you make a taco, it's all crazy in there. So you don't want them all going like too uniform. You want them in all different directions. The only thing is make sure your scored sides are the sides facing up. You want to be able to see those sides. Time for the cheese. Now you're gonna do the same thing as you did with the tomatoes. You're going to just roll them into balls and then boop. And then just cut them into some squares. These will be a little bit more uniformed than the tomatoes because to give the most like, you know, realistic, symbolic, kind of recognizable cheese look, you will want the pointy sides sticking out. I did 3 pieces of cheese and made sure the corners were all the parts facing out. All right, for the lettuce, you're going to use the same technique as you did with the beef and the tortilla shell. You're going to mix it with a little bit of yellow. You could also mix it with a little bit of white or light green. I didn't have those colors, so this is what I did. And then you're going to just flatten it out in a very uneven snake. And then I just made all sorts of kind of ridges and then folded it around kind of like a ribbon. There's no like wrong way to do this. It's supposed to look crazy, ununiform, whatever. And you can fix all your fillings. If anything falls out, like Mr. Cheese did here, you can always just pop them back in there after, move some tomatoes around, whatever you want to do. All right, so now that we have the filling all done, we want to give the tortilla its kind of realness, which I used a hard brush that I had, and I just started kind of stippling it onto my tortilla shell. And this will give it a nice dimpled, rough look to it. And then once you have that, you're gonna wanna give it some more color. I used a dark brown, like chalk pastel, and I just rubbed it on my brush and just put it in random spots, mostly on the edges, like where a tortilla would be more brown. And then bake it. All right, here she is. It's time for her little face. I looked on my phone for a bunch of cute little faces and I picked one of my favorites and just drew it on. Of course, this would be perfect, like without a face. I feel like this would make a awesome necklace or earrings, or anything like that. It'd be really funny and something, a conversation piece for sure. I just used the end of my brush here and dipped it in the paint, and these will give you perfect round pink little blushy cheeks. All right, so once you're happy with it, you are going to want to seal her up. And here she is, she's so cute. I love how the filling is just like spilling out of her. There's nothing better than just like a full taco. I actually made these for some phone cases I'm going to make in a future video. So I hope you enjoyed, and till next time.